was natural for us to say every religion must be respected. We weren't going to place one above the others. And that is the American way, to respect all religions. Anyone who suggests that some religion should be separated or isolated, or that one be given special favor over the others, hasn't read our Constitution. Now, some people will try to violate our values in New York City. We know that some people will not abide by our laws and will try to divide one New Yorker from another. Imam Tahir knows this, because in June, he was confronted by a man shouting anti-Muslim slurs, threatening him. And thank God, Imam was safe in the end. And NYPD arrested that man. And that is an indication of how we will confront bias and hatred. Any threat made against any New Yorker, a Muslim New Yorker or any other New Yorker, any threat or hate speech or violence will be confronted by the NYPD, by the city government, and there will be consequences for anyone who violates our laws and commits bias. We saw another example just last week, and it's one I made a very strong point of showing people of New York City, but I knew people all over the country were watching too, when police officer Emil Al-Qasadi was threatened in Brooklyn. She was off duty, as you know. She was threatened viciously and told by her assailant to quote unquote go back to her country. I made sure to stand by her at a press conference, and she was in her NYPD uniform that she's worn for 11 years serving the people of this country. She was wearing her hijab. She was a proud example of a public servant and a New Yorker dedicated to others. And she said the thing that people all over this city, all over this country needed to hear. She said, "I'm a Muslim woman, I'm a proud member of the New York City Police Department, and this is my country. I hope you feel the sense of solidarity I feel with you, that we will show that this great city, this open city, this city for everyone, we will win the day over hatred and intolerance. Thank you."